Hallelujah. Everlasting Father, we thank you, we appreciate your name for giving us the grace to be used by you, O Lord. We say may your name be exalted in the mighty name of Jesus. That we commit this teaching unto your hand, we pray you move with us in the mighty name of Jesus. Speak to us by yourselves. Let the eyes of our understanding be enlightened in the mighty name of Jesus. We call upon the spirit of wisdom. Let it begin to manifest in us. Let it begin to flow in us. Thank you, Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Hallelujah. I want to appreciate every one of us that have been following on in this teaching. I just want you to know that if we don't have you, the reason of our calling cannot be valuable. That it is you that make us to see the reasons of existence. And I pray the grace of the Lord will continue to be with you in the mighty name of Jesus. We begin a series teaching in the last time we met, and we begin to talk about the understanding of the grace of your calling and establish a certain fact that everyone has a call of God upon his life. That is, the moment you are born on earth, you are born for a purpose. And the moment you are born again, you are called for a purpose. I repeat, the moment you are born on earth, you are born for a purpose. And the moment you are born again, you are called for a purpose. That is, until you are born again, you can't be called by God. Because it is only the Spirit that can call you. And until you are born by the Spirit, you cannot understand what the Spirit is saying to your church. Because you are the church that the Spirit wants to speak to. And the book of Revelation says, let those that have the Spirit hear what the Spirit is saying to the church. So until you are born again, you can't receive the call of the Spirit. You can't hear when the Spirit calls you. So until you are born again, you can be called by God. And then establish a certain fact also that everyone is called by God. You don't need to have a caller to receive a calling. You don't need to be ordained by a pastor to receive a call. The call of God is of two types. Those that are called in the ministry and those that are called in the secular. And in the last teaching, I begin to give some certain credentials that qualify you to be part of those that are called into the ministry, and also some certain credentials that qualify you to be part of those that are called into the secular. And I said the first thing is that there is a certain grace that will attract men if you are calling the ministry. And if you are calling to the secular, there is a certain grace that will attract things. Because in this kingdom, the kingdom is ordained to be governed by two principles: the principle of spiritual blessing and the principle of material blessing. That is, the kingdom of God is established by power and the wisdom of God. And the kingdom of God is expanded by material blessing. So if you are calling to the ministry, the first thing that must begin to find expression in your life is either a dimension of God's power or a dimension of God's wisdom. You don't need money to start ministry. You need grace to start ministry. Two, you need men to start ministry. So the moment the grace of God begins to function in you, it will come, men, it will draw men into you. You don't struggle to look for men if you are called into the ministry. Naturally, everyone called into the ministry have the gift of men. Because the moment God called you, he will call some people with you. That's your protocol of calling. I repeat, the moment God called you into a certain assignment, he will call some people with you to work with you in that certain assignment, because there is no singular man that can carry out the assignment of God. A man can only champion the assignment of God, but no singular man that can carry the assignment of God. The assignment of God is too heavy for a singular man to carry. It's a joint work. I said when it comes to heavenly race, it can be personal, but when it comes to heavenly work, it is corporate work. I repeat, when it comes to heavenly race, it can be personal. But when it comes to heavenly work, it is not personal. You can never run the assignment of God personally. There are certain people that God has called with you to work with you in that ministry. You don't look for them. The grace of God upon your life will draw them to you. I repeat, you don't look for them. The grace of God upon their life will draw them to you effortlessly. I repeat, effortlessly. They will locate you.
they will be led to be with you. Because it is not purposely because of you, it is purposely because of Christ. Because when it comes to kingdom assignment, you are not the subject. That you are carrying the cow doesn't mean you are the subject. The subject is Christ. So we are just a co-laborer in this kingdom, in this assignment. So that you are carrying a vision, that doesn't mean you are special in the sight of God. Don't let that enter your head. Some people say, I'm a favorite of God. Who told you? You better humble yourself. In Christ, we are all one. Our fallen nature is the one that gives us different interpretations to a certain assignment. And begin to think some people, they are called into the apostles, so they have higher calling. So, pastor doesn't have higher calling. Who told you? In the kingdom, every call are equal. Either apostle or teacher, they are equal. Even in this kingdom, you can be a pastor and be greater than the apostle. Because it has nothing to do with call. It has something to do with those who have the ability to labor with the call. Paul said, I labor more than them all. Even though I'm the least, I labor more than them all. So even though you are the least in this kingdom, if you have the ability to labor with the grace of God upon your life, you will produce a tremendous result, more than somebody who is carrying the title of the apostle about without manifesting the mantle of the apostle. So I say this to you, that the moment you are called into the ministry, certain dimension of gift will begin to find expression in your life, and that gift will be a magnet that will draw men to you. And the moment men are drawn to you, money will surely be drawn to you. Get this and get this again. Get this again. You don't try to start ministry because you have money. Someone said, God is calling me to ministry. Say, I'm looking for money. Looking for money to do what? To start ministry. Is ministry a business? Is ministry a company that you are looking for money to start? It is company you look for capital. But when it comes to ministry, the first thing is that you have a encounter with God. Two, God's grace begin to find expression in your life. Three, by the grace of God upon your life, you establish the ministry. The moment that ministry is established upon the rock of Christ, it will surely attract men. And those men that was attracted, they have two types. One, men that will use their gifts for your calling. Two, men that will use their resources for your calling. Three, men that will use their time for your calling. Three men, I mean to say it. If you attract three different set of men, man, first, men that will use their gift for your calling, they will use their talent for the calling. Two, men that will use their resources for your calling. Three, men that will use their time for your calling. They are burden lifter. They use their time. They are with you always. So there are some people that are called to be with you in that assignment. It is not because of you, it is because of Christ. Because the motive is that Christ be glorified. So the same thing, if you are calling to the circular, get this and get this also. You can't be calling to the circular and be frustrated in the circular. If you are calling to the circular and you are frustrated in the circular, it's a pure evidence that you are walking out of the alignment of God upon your life. There are some people that God called them to be in the banking sector. They are looking for a federal government job. It is simply because they don't understand the kind of grace that is in their life and the certain position that God has strategized them to function effectively with that calling. So the moment you are called into circular, your life can never be void of material things, because God is the one that gives you the power to make wealth. People in the ministry, they don't receive power to make wealth; they receive power to build men. But people in the circular, they receive power to make wealth. So, and the moment the power to make weight begin to find expression in your life, it will surely attract things to you. And power to make weight can be of three types. One, it can come in form of supernatural ideas. Two, it can come in form of supernatural power. Three, it can come in form of supernatural favor. That is, it's either it comes in form of supernatural wisdom to establish a certain principles in the circular, to establish a certain things, to manifest a certain things, to manage a certain things in the circular, or it comes as a supernatural ability to produce a certain result with a certain grace and gift finding expression in your life, or it gives you a certain favor in the sight of man. There are some people that they don't do anything, man just like them. It's called spirit of favor, and that kind of favor is primarily for those that are calling to the circular. In the kingdom, your grace which naturally attracts favor in the ministry, I mean to say.
kalimo shanta lagada. Because the moment you are called into the circular, there are two different kind of people called into the circular. One, people with the ability to create things. Two, people with the ability to manage things. There are people that their assignment in the circular is not to create things. They don't create company, but create company and put them in that company. They have the ability to manage companies. They are good managers, but no good creators. But it is unfortunate now that somebody who is a good manager is trying to be a good creator. He want to create things by himself. At the end of the day, he start a company and the company didn't move because he doesn't have that grace. Not everybody have the grace to create something. There are some people that the way God wired them is to manage something. That they just put what you have created into their care. They have this multi-dimensional skills. They have this multi-talented grace to manage the things you put under their care. They can do 5-man job at the same time. But there are some people that they have the ability to create things. They are vision carrier in the circular. They are not vision manager. They are vision carrier. Vision carrier is different from vision manager. You know, what if, let me give this particular example. If you are the kind, if you are the type that you are a man of one thing, that is, you can't do two things at the same time. You just focus on one thing until you get results. You deny yourself from anything. You focus on one thing. Just simply know that you are likely to be a creator, not a manager. But if you are the type that you can do many things, you can learn many things. In this one, they will see you. In that one, they will see you. In another one, they will see you. You are likely to be a good manager, not a good creator. Because many people that God used to establish things, they are men of one thing. They deny themselves from anything to focus on singular thing. But many people that God used to manage things, they are not men of one thing. They are men of many things. So if you are multi-talented people, just know that there is tendency for you not to have the ability to start something and fulfill it. Because people with multi-dimensional grace, they have one kind of problem. Once they start something and there's no result, they quit and go and start another thing. Start another thing again, no result, they quit. At the end of the day, they end up having more than 6 keys. Some will have 10 jobs they have learned. None of them is producing results for them. So you must be able to understand the structural way God has wired you. Am I wired into the ministry or am I wired into the circular? Now, let's hear this. Because I want to focus on those that are called into circular today. Then in this next teaching, we will talk mainly on those that are called into the ministry. Hear this. Highest percentage of the assignment of God in this kingdom is in the circular, not in the ministry. I repeat. Highest percentage of the assignment of God in this kingdom is in the circular, not in the ministry. He said, let thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth, not thy will be done in church. Thy will be done on earth as it is done in heaven, not thy will be done in church as it is done in heaven. Church is part of the kingdom on earth. The church is not the kingdom on earth. Establishing church is not establishing kingdom. The church, the ministry is part of the kingdom on earth. But the ministry is not primarily the kingdom of Christ on earth. So when Christ said, upon this rock will I build my church. Church is not house. It's not coming together like house like this and we are fellowshipping, we sing praise and worship, then offering, then tithe. Then man of God will now come to the podium and preach 30 minutes and call out a call and we close. That is not church. That is just coming together of church. Because it is church that comes together. Church, they come together. That is school. In the realm of the school, what we call church nowadays is ordained to be a school of the spirit, not church. What we call church is designed by God to be a school of the spirit. Where believer comes together to be built. Where believer comes together to be trained. Where believer comes together to be groomed. So that they will have the ability to fulfill the assignment in the circular. So that they will have the ability to fulfill the assignment on earth. The major assignment of the kingdom is not in the church, but on earth. Get this, church work started on Monday morning, not on Sunday service. I repeat, church work, God's work started on Monday morning. It is unfortunate that some people will be running out of the circular. They say they have missed Sunday service or they have missed weekly service. I advise you, if you have assignment, if God is calling to circular, run from Sunday service and go to your assignment in the circular. Because the assignment of Christ, it is not in church, it's on earth. Let thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is done where? In heaven, not that will be done in church. Church is part of the kingdom of Christ on earth. God wants, Christ wants to establish his kingdom everywhere. He wants to establish his kingdom in the academic sector, establish his kingdom in the political system of Nigeria, of this country, establish his kingdom system in the health sector. He wants to establish his kingdom. And the kingdom is not building. The kingdom is righteousness, peace, and joy. In what? In the Holy Ghost. Anywhere you see righteousness, that the kingdom of God has established there. The kingdom of Christ is not building. The kingdom of Christ is not RUCCG. The kingdom of Christ is not living faith. The kingdom of Christ is not mountain of fire. The kingdom of Christ is not Matthew 6:33 apostolic ministry. The kingdom of Christ is not conferences of immortality. The kingdom of Christ is righteousness, peace, and joy in the Holy Ghost. So the moment righteousness, peace, and joy is finding expression in the political system of Nigeria is a pure evidence that the kingdom of Christ has been established there. If righteousness, peace, and joy is finding expression in the health sector of this country is a pure evidence that the kingdom of Christ has been established there. So let everyone get this. 80% of the assignment of the kingdom of this kingdom of Christ on earth is designed to be in the secular, not in the ministry. Only few people are called into the ministry. Only few people are called into the ministry. The major assignment is into the secular. Maleko Shantala Gadaya. So if you are calling to the secular, get that understanding very well. The highest percentage of the assignment is in to the secular. And the moment you are calling to the secular, pay attention to this three thing. If you are calling to the secular, pay attention to this three thing. First, you are an evangelist called to change system. If you are calling to the secular, just know this, you are an evangelist called to change system. Get this. It is in church you change people. But there are people that God is raising from the church to go into the earth, to go into the world, to change system. Kalimo Shantaya. There is difference between changing people and changing system. If we only focus on changing people, I say this to you, system will put them in bondage. If we only focus on changing system, I say this to you, men who are corrupt will corrupt the system again. So there are people that God has ordained to change system, and if you are called into the ministry, you don't have the assignment to change system. You can't change any system in the political system. You cannot. You can only be shouting on social media. There is nothing you can do. The highest thing a priest can do is to raise men that will go into the circular and change system. So the moment you have assignment in the circular, one of your primary assignment is to change system. Number two, say your second assignment is to win souls. The plan of God is to ensure that church is a place where souls are built. The world is a place where souls are won. He said, go into the world and win the soul. When Jesus said, go into the world, he didn't say we should choose ourselves to and be sharing tracts. That's not what he said. Go into the world system. Gain admission into the university. When you get admission, you are going into the world. So the reason why you are getting admission is to change the system. When you seek for a job in the banking industry, you are going into the world. When you put in for lecturing job in any university, you have an obligation to change that system for the kingdom. So you are going into the world. There are certain platforms through which you need to go into the world. It is not by sharing tract tutu. That is a religious way of winning souls. God will help the church. So the moment you are calling to the circular, you are an evangelist of the kingdom. Everyone calling to the circular is an evangelist. One, to change system. Two, to what? To win souls. And the soul you have won, you have the responsibility to now bring them into the church where that souls can be built. So the purpose of the church is to build soul, not to win soul. We don't win soul in the church. Church is not a place where you call attacker. It is this alignment that make the church to be the place where you call attacker. Church is not a place where you call attacker. Church is a place where you build those that have been won. The first attacker was not called in church. He was called on the day of Pentecost. And that was in the street. The second attacker also wasn't called in the church. He was called in the street. Attacker is meant to be called in the market. Attacker is meant to be called in the banking industry. Other call is meant to be called in the political system. Those that have been won into the kingdom, those that have been translated from the kingdom of darkness into the kingdom of light, they have the obligation to build in the church and be built by those priests that God has raised in the church.
So first thing, you have the assignment of winning the soul, of changing the system. Second, you have the assignment of winning the soul. Third, you have the assignment of investing with the resources that God has given to you to expand the kingdom of God in the church. That's the third assignment. So we call them kingdom financier. That is, you have the obligation to use the resources, because the moment God is calling you to circular, it will surely bless you with wealth. Forget about it. You can't be called into circular and be standard. There will be this abundant dimension of financial blessing that will begin to find expression in your life. And one of the assignments of that blessing is to use it to build the church. To build the church. To expand the church. To expand the kingdom. To expand ministry. Then the third assignment of those that are called into circular is to build the material life of men. Every man has two lives. He has spiritual life. He has natural life. That is to invest in men. Can I just say, it is motivational speaker that tell you to invest in real estate. In this kingdom, we invest in real people. Motivational tells you to invest in real estate, that is the best investment. But I tell you that in this kingdom, God didn't raise you primarily to invest in real estate. That is good, but God raised you primarily to invest in real people. It is better to invest in real people than to invest in real estate. There are people that God bless you. You can begin to sponsor two people abroad to UK every year. You have the financial ability, but you are busy buying land about. At the end of the day, can I say this to you? If you invest in real people, those men will buy land for you. If you understand the kingdom, church needs to be restructured. If you can understand this four, you will know that you have more assignment in the circular than the church. And I say this again, 80% of the assignment is to the circular, not to the church. Only few are called to handle the church. And I pray God will bless you in the mighty name of Jesus. In the next teaching, we'll talk about the roles of a priest in the church. Thank you very much.